And speaking of cars, I had an experience a few days ago in buying a new car. I don't know whether this ever happened to you. I walked out of my house, and on the windshield of my old car was a tag. Would you take $2,000 for your car towards the purchase of a new one? Signed, Ed Johnson. Well, I figured he escaped, because I looked at my car and I knew he couldn't have meant me. Well, I raced my car down to the agency, and I beat it by 4 blocks. Walked in, looked in the window, most beautiful cars. And a fella came out and he says, come on in, they're bigger than ever and they last a lifetime. He was talking about the payments. You should have seen this fella. He looked something like a vulture. He had a smile on his face, a smile in a suit, and a smile on his commission. So I walked in and looked at this car. It was a magnificent car. Stereophonic sound, cinemascope color, platinum wheels. There was a cop sitting in it watching it. And there were 3 signs around it. And the first sign said, please do not touch the car. And the second sign said, please do not touch the sign that said, do not touch the car. And the third sign said, please do not read the other 2 signs. Well, I walked over, looked at the car, and the salesman put on a cashmere glove and he rubbed the hood. And he said, this is a car. This is a car. He said it like the rest of them are bicycles. I says, well, how much? He said, $7,700 for you. I said, $7,700 for me? He says, it's a deal. I said, how do you make a profit? He said, I juggle the books. So I took a look at the car, and all of a sudden I spotted something that would be my style. A nice little coupe, you know. So I asked him, how much is that coupe in the back? And he said, you mean to tell me that you have the nerve to ask about that car and this one in the same breath? In the same breath? So I figured maybe he's right. So I asked him again. How much is that one? And how much is this one? I figured if I separated the breaths, he wouldn't get too angry. Well, he started to swell. And he grew. And he looked down at me. And he was shorter than I was. Well, to make a long story short, I bought the car. And I said, incidentally, I'd like to get $2,000 for my other one. I have a note here from Ed Johnson. He said he just quit. And I tell you something, ladies and gentlemen, although you abuse, and that really isn't the word, I should say, although you satirize or enjoy some of the things that your wives do to you, they're great with directions. My wife is fabulous with directions. For instance, one night I had a very important engagement. She had taken my tuxedo to the cleaners. And I asked her, where is it? I'd like to go pick it up. And she was busy cooking, so I had to go. And she said, well, you get in the car and you go right. And you come to a house with beautiful green shutters, with a yellow picket fence. And you make a left there. And you go past a beauty parlor that I don't go near. So don't stop there. And as you continue, you'll see a man selling peanuts on the corner. It's right across the street. Well, you know the peanut man moved and I ended up in Philadelphia? But you know, with all the kidding and all the humor that you do on the so-called lovely wife, mother, whatever the case may be, you can't get away from the fact that they give you the greatest gift in the world, and that's children. I have 3. 1 of each.